So some of the things that I learned, excuse me. Hey everyone. You wanna get on bed? So before I go ahead and get into what today's video is about, I did just want to say that, like, excuse my appearance. This is just like a sit-down talk through like what happened in clinicals video with me, and I kind of wanted it to seem casual and like just like I was talking to you and explaining it to you as a friend or something. So I wasn't gonna like get dressed up or make it some big ordeal because there's no need. Also, I did want to apologize for how long I've been going without uploading. It was because I was focusing on school. Like I said, I will always put school before YouTube because I know that is something that will lead me towards something that is permanent, and YouTube may not be here forever. Plus, I'm not like too popular, so it's not like I make money from it or anything. So I'm just working towards something that will help me to make money. So just so I wouldn't forget anything, because I already tried to film this video once, I went ahead and this time put notes in my laptop so that I can talk about specific things and not ramble on and not forget things. So I'm gonna go ahead and get on my laptop. Okay, so my clinicals was 4 days long. It was Thursday, Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, and the shift that we worked was second shift, but we didn't work like the full shift. We did 4 to 10, and they do more like 3 to 11. So that is the first thing I wanted to note. Mine was at a nursing home that was about 35 to 45 minutes away from my house. It depended on traffic and if it was nighttime or the daytime, because in the day it took about 45 and at night it took about 35. So we went to our clinicals with our instructor that was our week one instructor, because after week one she said that her plate was too busy and that she just couldn't be our instructor anymore, but that she would still do clinicals with us. So she still went ahead and did clinicals with us. It wasn't with a complete stranger or anything, but it also wasn't with who taught us the rest of the course. So on the first day of clinicals, I went in and I was extremely nervous to begin with, just because I was working with real patients. I didn't know if I was going to be able to do some of the things. I just didn't know really what to expect. We've been working on mannequins and we've been in the school, and then we went to a setting where we were with real patients and we were with other CNAs, and we really had to do our job correctly. There was no time for mistakes or anything like that. So I went in really nervous. The CNA that they had me under the first 2 days was a CNA that's also in nursing school, so I thought that was cool because we could relate as to, you know, what we're working towards and our future goals. And then the second 2 days I was with a CNA that has been a CNA for 20 plus years, so she's very experienced and, you know, it's just a good person to work with. Both of them were, so I'm really thankful for them. So when I walked in on the first day, I was so intimidated, because the setting just, I don't know what I was expecting, but it just, I don't know, I was just really nervous. I walked in, there's patients all in the hall because, you know, they don't want to be in their rooms all day. Sometimes the people with dementia and Alzheimer's just roam around and stuff like that. So it was really intimidating to see just a lot of people in the hallway yelling and things like that. And then this one lady, the entire time I was there, I'm not sure why, I'm not going to say names or anything like that, obviously, but she, the first day, stuck her tongue out at me and then threw her like ice cream stick at me. And I was like, just really intimidated because I didn't know if they were going to harm me or what or anything like that. Obviously they didn't, but it was just intimidating to walk in and then that's the first thing that happens to you. And the first day was basically just me assisting my CNA with a lot of things rather than doing things on my own. So that was day one. Day two and three, I went in a lot more confident because day one I thoroughly enjoyed, and it was just like, you know, just as easy as doing it on the mannequin. Well, it's not as easy because you have like real body weight, but I'm saying like I wasn't forgetting my steps. I knew I was doing everything right and that I was working with the same CNA that I had worked with the day before, so that made me more comfortable and I just went in a lot more confident. And you know, I knew how to talk to the patients better, because the first day I wasn't talking loud enough, and you know, a lot of people in nursing home have hearing problems, so you have to speak a little louder to them. And I got the hang of that, and I just got the hang of how the whole nursing home worked together in general. So I knew how to do my tasks better and the things that they assigned me to do. I knew where things were, I knew patient names, so it was a lot better than day one. on the last day of my clinicals, I did pretty much everything on my own. Like, the CNA I was working with, me and her work in the same hall, obviously. But if a call light went on, I would go answer it on my own. And if I could do what they needed me to do, I would do it by myself rather than going to get my CNA and saying, hey, can I do this? Or hey, can you help me do this? I just take the initiative to go and do it on my own. Day 4 was also the busiest day. And it was just like call light after call light after call light. And I took so many steps. Like, I looked on my phone and seen how many steps I had taken. And it was just like, overall, the most just, I don't know how to describe it, but I feel like a day in the of a CNA, that's more how it is, just so fast-paced. So some of the things that I learned, like, during this whole experience was that depending on what nurses and things are there, you really do have a completely different day because of the way, like, certain people do things or how fast they get things done, such as, like, giving medications and stuff. Obviously, the earlier you give your patients the medication, obviously CNAs don't give medication, I'm speaking of like RNs and stuff, obviously the earlier they give their medication, the earlier the patients are going to go to sleep, which makes it easier on you because you're not getting call out after call out after call out after call out. But on different days, when like you have a different nurse or something, it really does change the whole dynamic because they do things differently, obviously, and it helps it either to run smoother or to run worse. So I learned about that. I also just like overall learned just like how the day of a CNA really is and if this is something I wanted to do or not. And it is, I'm really excited that I did this because it completely solidified like my path and why I chose to do this first. Because first of all, everybody says it's such a humbling experience, and I can already see that it is, because you're literally helping people that cannot help themselves. And then it's just like getting your foot in the medical field. And then, you know, when you're in nursing school and you're working your way up, you're going to be so appreciative that you did this. And a lot of people aren't built to do it. Like, it's hard work, but if you have the heart for it, I definitely recommend doing it because there is a demand for CNAs. Like, America does not have enough. So now I'm just going to speak of some things we did, and I'm not going to go over every little thing because obviously I had to complete a whole bunch of skills to get checked off, but I'm just going to go over some of the things we did. So some of the things that were delegated to me that, you know, aren't in the job duty of a CNA or aren't at one of the skills you get checked off on is passing ice and snacks. Once a shift, they had to get their ice water changed, so we did that. I set up the dining room, like I moved the chairs out of the way for the patients that will wheel themselves, and then I like pass out straws, put ice in cups, things like that. So, you know, you do various different things. You're not just doing like changing a patient and activities of daily living, but you're also helping around the place. Obviously, I answered call lights because, I mean, that's what CNAs do, they give and help whatever the patient needs. So I'm pulling up some of the skills so that I can go over some of the things we did. One of the things we did is vital signs manually, because they usually do it electronically, but we had to get checked off manually. So I did that, and I recorded like things on my notepad that I needed to report to my CNA so that she can chart. I recorded things like that. Skills wise, I pretty much did everything. Like, I dressed a client with an affected weak side, I measured urine, provided dental or denture care, things like that. So, you know, I had to get checked off on all that stuff for the state and during my clinical experience. Overall, I will say that it solidified my pathway and what I wanted to do, and it gave me that reassurance that I needed to keep going and that this is the field that I wanted to enter, and that, you know, it was always between dentistry and this for me, and that this is what I want to do. I grew close with the workers just in the few days that I was there, so I know that those people, like, are people you could get really close to. I don't know why I can't talk. I had my patients literally ask me how long I was going to be there, and when I told them that I wasn't going to be there too long, they literally asked me to come back and said stay because I'm so good and I helped them so much. One of the patients literally cried to me and told me that she was sorry that she kept causing us trouble, and I was like, it's okay, like, you're not causing us trouble, this is our job, this is what we're here to do, like, I'm here to help. And she was crying because she was so appreciative for us, and she told us that, you know, she won't be alive when we're older, but she hopes somebody will take care of her as well as we are. And that literally just touched my heart because, like, these people are so appreciative for the things that you're doing for them that they can no longer do for themselves. Like, imagine not being able to go to the bathroom on your own. Imagine you know, not being able to even pull your dentures out on your own, like, that is just crazy, you know, to think about. And you want someone to take care of you when you're in that position, or your family member when they're in that position. So it's just a really rewarding job. On my review sheet after clinicals, where your instructor just basically goes through and marks you and gives you an overall score, I got all ones, which means that I exceeded expectations in all areas. The big thing that I wanted to announce is that I was offered a job at the facility we were doing the clinicals at, and that after I take my state exam, that is where I'll be applying and working second shift with the girls that I was working with. So I'm very excited about that, and I'm so thankful for that opportunity, because they do pay pretty well, and I'm already familiar with the place and the patients and things like that. So I'm very excited about that, and I'm so looking forward to working there. I have my final and my skills review next week, which is where we take the final and then we do every skill for the facility. And then within a week, we should be scheduled to take our state exam, and hopefully I pass. So please wish me luck, and please keep me in your thoughts and prayers. I'm just gonna be watching videos and taking practice tests to hopefully prepare me for everything that I'm having to do within the next week. And I just pray that I do so well, and that, you know, I pass the first try everything. But I really hope this video was helpful. I really hope that you enjoyed it, and if you did, make sure you like, subscribe, and comment, and stay tuned for more content.